Do you know there are debate in America about whether adults should celebrate Halloween? And if you are Christian, you probably have questioned at one time or another whether you should celebrate Halloween, because obviously it's a pagan holiday. Or is it? Let's find out with People Also Ask. Hi, I'm Michelle. Welcome to Why People Also Ask, where I search something seemingly obvious on Google and share with you some of those pop, aka People Also Ask.Which is a feature telling you what other people are searching on Google that related to your query. Believe me, some of those parts will really turn your world upside down. Like, you have no idea what's the deal with Halloween. You really don't. So today's keyword is Halloween. Let's start with the first part. Why is Halloween so popular?The answer to this question was extracted from an article titled Why Has Halloween Become So Popular Among Adults? Published by The Conversation, which is a network of not-for-profit media outlets that publish copyright-free news stories on the internet. Here's what extracted by Google. Halloween has always promised the chance to be creative and to become something else, but in embracing the holiday, emergent adults are doing more than reject traditional adulthood. They are playing with identity in a way that puts their skills and cultural competence to work. The first thought that came to my mind after I read this article is, what the hell is this paragraph talking about? Here, I want to remind you that Google's People Also Ask are algorithmically extracted by Google, so sometimes they do make a mistake and extract something out of context. That's why I always read their original article too.As it turns out, it's a very thought-provoking article talking about why Halloween has become more popular among young adults specifically. In 2005, just over half of young adults celebrated Halloween. By 2018, that number has grown to over 70%. The author argued that the young adult's embrace of Halloween could have something to do with the fact that adulthood itself has changed. Here's some excerpt from the article.If Halloween has become more popular among adults, it's because traditional markers of adulthood have become less clear and less attainable. Traditional markers of adult responsibility and independence, aka family, career, home ownership, have either been delayed or abandoned altogether, by choice or necessity. Transitions to adulthood have become uncertain, drawn out, and complicated.He also pointed out several other theories that proposed by sociologists and cultural critics to explain this phenomenon. I highly encourage you to read this whole article. The link is in the description. For some reason, I related to this article quite a lot. When my mom was my age, she already had a kid, and she already has her own family, own career, and look at what am I doing now, making YouTube video and carefree, which I will argue is a more enjoyable lifestyle in a lot of ways.So let's move on to the next part. Where is Halloween banned? The answer to this question was extracted from an article titled This Halloween, Some US Town Will Ban Teens from Trick-or-Treating, published by Court, which is a business-focused English-language international news organization. It is launched in New York City in 2012 and is owned by Japanese media company Kouzabase. Again, Google made a mistake.Because this answer extracted by Google is specifically referring to banning teens from trick-or-treating, not about banning Halloween altogether. But still, it's a very interesting article talking about they are actually seeking making it illegal for teens to trick-or-treat, and you can actually go to prison for that. How old is too old to go trick-or-treating as Halloween approaches? Chesapeake, Virginia says the answer to that question is anyone over the age of 12.City officials recently announced that doorbell ringing candy seekers over the age of 12 could face a misdemeanor charge, up to 6 months in jail and $25 to $100 fines. What? Imagine your children go trick-or-treating and end up in jail. What's wrong with those politicians? It's not like celebrating Halloween is a sin or something. Wait, maybe it is, because obviously there are a lot of people asking, is Halloween a sin on Google?Which is the next part we are gonna talk about? The answer to that question was extracted from an article titled Is Celebrating Halloween a Sin? Published by LullabyLark.com, which I believe is a personal blog of a Christian monk named Aaron. Here's the excerpt extracted by Google. In understanding whether celebrating Halloween is a sin, we have to know that it is based on both pagan and Catholic traditions of connecting with the dead in hopes to gain power in pagan tradition or to make intersection.In Catholic tradition, but the scripture makes it clear that neither is possible. Again, if you don't read the whole article, you probably will think this excerpt kind of out of context. So I have read the article for you. I believe this article represents the viewpoint of the Protestant, but not of the Catholics. It pointed out that Halloween has both pagan and Catholic roots. It has pagan roots because it is widely believed that Halloween originated from an ancient Celtic festival of Samhain. Celts believed that on Samhain, the soul of the dead would visit their home, and that those who had died in the past year would travel to the next world. As a result, people would light bonfires and wear costumes to ward off ghosts, which later became the tradition of wearing costumes in Halloween and jack-o'-lantern. They also believed that the presence of the spirit can enhance their priestly druid's ability to predict the future. As to the Catholic root of Halloween, it has something to do with the All Souls Day in Catholic calendar, especially the practice called souling, where the poor will go around asking for a pastry called soul cake with the promise of praying for the donor's deceased loved one, which later became the tradition of trick-or-treating. But why do they pray for the deceased, you ask? As it turns out, a lot of Catholics in medieval time believe almost all Catholics will go to purgatory where they will be tortured by fire until they are purified. The good news is, unlike hell, which a non-believer will go after they die, Catholics only go to purgatory, which is temporary. But temporary can mean a very long time. According to an article titled Tezos on 7 Years in Purgatory for Everything, published by Pathio, which is an online media company providing information and commentary about religion. In medieval times, it has been widely taught that each sin must be punished by 7 years of purgatorial fire. Let's say that you are a very good person and only commit one sin per day, which is not very likely because that including eating too much butter and use Facebook as a verb. But let's say you only commit one sin per day and you will be facing 2,555 years for the things you commit per year. And if you live to 70, you'll be facing 178,850 years of suffering in purgatory. Isn't that crazy? That's why it is so important to pray for the dead, because they also believe the prayer can shorten the time your loved one spending in purgatory. But this kind of belief also enabled the corrupt practice of selling indulgences, which later provoked Martin Luther's reformation of the church. Well, that explained why most of the Protestants don't approve of the concept of purgatory, hence they don't approve of All Souls Day, hence they don't approve of even the Catholic root of Halloween. But we know not all Christians oppose Halloween, because the next text is Halloween Pagan is extracted from an article titled Guess What? Halloween is More Christian Than Pagan, published by the Washington Post. This article is written by Beth Ellisenbar, who is a historian at Baylor University, who is also a Christian monk who does celebrate Halloween. According to Beth, we have very little evidence about the actual practice of Celt people and their festivals, and most of the traditions we associate with Halloween are actually medieval or early modern in their origin, not pagan. I recommend you to read this whole article if you got a chance. I will put a link in the description too. Very interesting article. Alright, that's recap. Today we learned that there are a lot of crazy city bending teens from trick-or-treating. There are more adults are now celebrating Halloween, and they do have their reason. There are some Catholic and Christian do celebrate Halloween, while other Catholic or Christian do not. During my past trip, I read another very interesting article titled Religious Root, Secular Festivities, Halloween Takes a Hit in School, published by Hartford Courant, which is a daily newspaper in Connecticut. This article talking about the predicament school facing when trying to deciding whether to celebrate Halloween or not, because by doing so, they will exclude children whose religious prohibited the celebration of Halloween. So today my question is, do you think there should be Halloween celebration in public school? Let me know your thought. Bye!